Rosi, Dr. Rosi, I'm just wondering, is this the first time a research project of this magnitude has the three universities working together?
Yes, and one of the main themes on this project is climate justice, and I'm sure Professor Shameem and Professor Nabobo Mamba know what it means. You know, it's the bottom line is that everyone, irrespective of age, culture, cultural background, or wherever you are, you must be able to have access to this information. We must be able to exchange this information to be able to ensure that our communities are climate ready and are able to, and consequently we are able to reduce risks and damages that will be brought about by climate by climate change. And we are so very fortunate because USP can't do it alone. To reach the mass of our population, we need everyone to be working together. And I'm so very delighted as well to be part of this project with the two sister universities. Awesome. And of course, the media in ensuring that our stories are visible and heard by members of our community.
Thank you, Dr. Rosi. Professor Shameem, if I can just ask you, how does the university hope to be transformed, and what are the university's role in transforming communities?
Well, one of the most important aspects of our strategic plan is that we've got to have community engagement. So we're involved in teaching, we're involved in research, and the third aspect is, you know, in fact, more, even more important, and that is to know what your community is like. And this is why we're focusing this on our community, which is in Vunda. So you know, the University of Fiji is located formally in the, you know, just very, very formally in that area, and we have a very good relationship with the traditional owners. So we're going to be using their wisdom as well and asking them to participate in this. And one of the things I didn't mention was that it's something that I have wanted to do for a very long time, and I think we're well placed to do it with this project, is record traditional medicine as well. So Professor Bamba had actually referred to women's knowledge. And it's usually, medicine is, traditional medicine is usually women's knowledge. So there will be teams of our students working on different things. So there'll be a team that's involved in sailing, learning how to sail the drua and building a drua as well. There'll be another team looking at patents, like how to not just record medicines, but also patent them, because intellectual property about indigenous medicine and traditional knowledge in medicine is something that is really just at its early stages right now. And so we want to do that. So the law students will be involved in that. The business students will be involved in and putting up business plans for conservation. And the science students will be involved in the scientific aspects of navigation and other things. And so the entire, and education, of course, is a broader field too, in traditional education. So the whole university is going to be involved in it. So that's how it's going to transform the university. We will be working as a community, first within the university as well, but also then engaging with our community that lives around us. And not just in terms of the coastal areas, but going out into the closest Mamanuthu Islands, because the drua won't be able to sail too far and there's a time factor involved, but also going to the closest Mamanuthu Islands to also get involved with whatever the community is doing, and perhaps helping to build seawalls. You know, I mean, this is a real practical thing for students. Students tend to sit in libraries and, you know, just be looking at books and their computer. We want them to get out and help the community regenerate itself if it needs it, but also learn from the community too. So it's a two-way process. That's how it's going to transform us.
Thank you very much, Professor Shameem. Professor Nabobo Mamba, would you say the same for your university?
Correct. We also have, in addition to Professor Shameem, we take the same pattern. We also have a food scientist in FNU, formerly of USP, and she's going to come along to look at how women and young people, youth, and men, of course, because, you know, the men are important as well, but she's interested in how, you know, in Vungalei, the FNU focal point, they don't really like to eat breadfruit. So we are hoping that we will help each other, us and them, in terms of bringing our students, in terms of bringing our different strengths of staff, not only from FNU, from USP, because Rosie's done a lot of that herself, and Professor Shameem as well. We are going to work and bring together all our strengths. In Vungale, there's need for the food. Eh? It's the food security, Mavis. We're hoping that Dr. Chime Malako will influence those who don't want to eat their uto to show them how to turn it into flour and have it like roti. Because in Vungale, we like our roti. Would you believe it? So we are the kingdom that does that. So honestly, so they won't eat the breadfruit, but they will eat the roti. So, you know, more than like further to what Professor Shameem said, we also, you know, and that is to share, that's expertise to share across the universities. She's been doing work in that in Lau, Professor Dr. Chimay Malako. So she's been doing organic food, natural food out of Vidya. So it's been, she has also a coffee shop that does natural products. So she's done that at USP. Now she's with us at FNU. So we are open to share our resources in this. But like what Professor Shamimi said, we are a river environment that we are trying to look after. So we are excited to go on the draw, but when you come to Vungale, you are on the river and we are climbing a few forest areas. So a really good balance. And our students, just like Professor Shameem said, our students will be involved in all these things that we will do. Eh? So in reviving and enhancing the water system for drinking, in looking after the river that is caving into the village with scientific help, and maybe we also will have diggers dig through the village to get the water out. And the food security aspect, the vegetable plots, the workshops that run with that, we are going to involve our students and staff. And we are looking forward to also going with Rosie and Professor Shameem in these various settings. Thank you, Mavis. Back
Thank
to you.
Thank you very much, Professor Baba. It's so exciting to hear.
It is. It is. We can't wait to go.
Involving all your students in this. And yes, what better way to spread awareness than have your students going themselves and you know, participate. Dr. Rosi, would you like to add something more?
Yes.
Mavis, the research project is in two parts. So we have the survey, where we find out from our students about climate change education, their perspective, you know, what's already there, what are they doing, and what can be done to improve what's already been done. And the second part is the participatory action research, which, you know, everyone is involved in, not just the students, but also our community members, the university, the three universities, and also stakeholders. And when saying stakeholders, we also include the government, because they will be assisting us with seeds and other technical advice. And so, you know, this project is for everyone, by everyone, for everyone. So we were really excited, and I'm so grateful that the two sister universities are coming on board and assisting us with this. And the bottom line is, it's our people's lives that are at stake due to climate change. So we are here to help transform the minds of our people, as well as transform our communities, so that we can have a more resilient and sustainable one.
And who better to do than the big three? Professor Shameem, if I can just ask you to just, you know, share a few more words before we wrap up our Zoom session this morning.
Sure. So thank you very much, Mavis. Just the last word I'd forgotten to mention earlier on is that we're going to film this whole project for ourselves, so that it's a proper, like, it will be a proper documentary, not just a, you know, recording, which we would normally do by way of participatory research that Dr. Lange mentioned. So we're going to make a documentary out of it that we will then enter into the international film festivals, because that's awesome. Really important. Climate change is at the top of everyone's list right now. And to have a 20-minute video made by professionals is something that we really want to do. And also, it's great for posterity, because, you know, even if we've finished with the project, we've written our final project report and so on, and, you know, people have gone and it's forgotten. Whereas if it's, there's a film record, then it's at least in the archive somewhere, and somebody will bring it out in the future and say, oh, those people were great ancestors because they helped to preserve the environment. So to be a good ancestor is really about the bottom of this, even though, you know, it's not talking about the next generation, but it's talking about 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 generations in the future, that they can look back and say, oh, these guys really tried to help to conserve the environment, which is really deteriorating at the time. It's almost like we have no control over it, because it's other countries with carbon emissions and so on that have control, but we're the ones who are suffering the effects of it. So what are we doing in terms of trying to get the local knowledge and the traditional knowledge to be able to conserve that? That's the thing. And I think there's a real good value-added aspect to this, to be able to report it in the right way. So apart from that, Mavis, I just wanted to show the symbol of the, you know, the project for ourselves, and I've already shared it with the other two wonderful ladies. So I'm sure they won't mind it if we just bring that on, if you can.
No worries, we shall. There you go.
We haven't been able to see it, but anyway, I'm sure you have.
Yes. We can see it.
Okay, well, it's great if the people will see it. So, you know, the ladies have got a copy of it as well, so everyone has. So that's going to be the symbol of our particular project, but we are in unison with the other two as well. So it's going to be a fantastic, like I think Dr. Lange mentioned, that this has not been done before. And it's interesting that the women are driving it, of course. That's the best part of it, you know, that you've got these strong women of the Pacific who are looking at this and driving it, and also having the innovations, you know, the thought about behind it as well. And then leading the students, because, as I said, the students are the next generation. So all of us are like-minded on that.
Thank you very much, Professor Shameem. Professor Mbamba.
When Rosi talked about this and talked about Professor Shameem Mavis, I was really excited. I know that what Rosi touches is positive. So now that I've met Professor Shameem and her team, I'm very excited, more than excited. The best part of it is really documentation for our future generations. In the site that FNU has selected, Pan is going to be part of this, Nabobo. That is women's wealth, women's knowledge. Without Voivoi, you know, the soil is not protected, the river goes away. That is one art that is also an income generating capacity, has that. So yeah, like what Professor Shameem has said, I think our Takia Rosi is certainly set sail today in Vungale, because we are forested and we are very place-based, landed. It's going to perhaps look like the women's farming stick. It's called na indoko. So maybe the indoko or the digging stick. And our Wungale basket, which is, you can see, is part of my study, is going to be part of this. So yeah, reviving of traditional knowledge that has capacity for the future. But I like the film one. Professor Shameem, we probably work together on that as well with Rosi. We have a film unit in my college. Mm-hmm. So yeah, a lot of potential. And of course, Mavis as our partner, we'll get her strength in too. Thank you. We are so looking forward at FNU. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies. I'm so excited for the three universities. And of course, I can say this, when all of you put your heads and hands and students together on this, it certainly will turn into gold. And we're looking forward to that.
Amen to that.
Thank you very much,
ladies. Yes, we are. Yes.
Rosi and Professor Shameem and Professor Mbamba, it's been wonderful talking to you this morning. You all have a wonderful day, and we look forward to talking to you more in the future.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Bye-bye. Mwande manda, everyone.
Mwande manda all. Be nice.